Hello, everyone. I just got back from seeing a little movie that involves this guy. It's really late as I'm recording this. In fact, 8:58. As I'm recording this, I just got home not more than 2 minutes ago, at minimum. Probably five at maximum. So I just kind of wanted to put this review up. It's Batman vs. Superman: Dawn of Justice. It just came out tonight, two and a half, almost 3 hours ago right now. And I have some thoughts, so I'm gonna talk about it. I forgot to bring my notebook, but I'll pretend like I'm doing things. So first, an overview, a picture that I shall paint for you. But first, let's because I want to get into spoiler territory, but I can't do that because it just came out. Some of you have seen it, some of you haven't. Some of you are in the theater right now or waiting to get into the theater. It's directed by Zack Snyder, of 300, Watchmen, lots of movies. He's made a Sucker Punch. Made those movies. Your leads are Henry Cavill as Superman, Jesse Eisenberg as Lex Luthor, and Ben Affleck as Batman. Really weird cast. It was released tonight. Technically, it was released Monday. I think that's when people saw it. Monday for people who saw the trailer, Tuesday for the critics, and then Thursday for the rest of us folk, like me. So the premise is Batman's mad at Superman for destroying Metropolis, so he's gonna go kill him, or just have it out with him. And yeah, I mean, there's very little I can talk about this movie without spoiling it. But to give you a general impression of my thoughts on the movie is, I summed it up in a text with my mom. I said, let me find the text. I think I said, the story was very disjointed, like three movies in one. It would be like if Civil War happened when Iron Man came out. And I'll get into that a little bit later when I talk about the story, because that's one of its biggest problems. And I will talk about universe building and all that, but I'm gonna save most of that for my spoiler review, or spoiler discussion. So the acting's pretty good here. Everyone's getting given things to do. It fills that 2 hours and 30 minutes real well, really well. Except for the standard action movie where there's like a lull, like in the last quarter of the movie, there's just this lull that's like, okay, we're not doing anything, we're just waiting on things to happen. You know, there's that standard stuff, but you can't really knock it. It's an action movie first and foremost. The standouts here are honestly, I really thought Amy Adams was pretty good in here, because it actually gives Lois Lane something to do than be like, "Save me, Clark!" Even though that happens a lot in this film, which I'm not too proud of. They give Lawrence Fishburne a nice role here as kind of the comedic humor guy, interstitched with some of the stuff that's happening with Superman, Batman, all that stuff. I really liked him. I didn't like him in Man of Steel, but I like him in this movie. He's pretty good. They actually took some notes. I will say one criminally underused character is the guy who Henry Lennox plays. General. He's in this movie. But I mean, did you guys not think he was going to be in the movie? Or generally want to know. He's in this movie. He's at the announcement of Batman vs. Superman when they announced it 2 years ago at Comic-Con, something like that. It's like, remember me, or whatever. Remember my hand at your throat. But anyways, he's very much kind of just put in there, like, hey, you're a Man of Steel, come play in our cinematic universe now. So, just pretty cool, thing that happened. Camera work, was there any? I mean, the most interesting shot, is honestly the most interesting part cinematically is when, oh, I know I need some updates, Windows, but thank you, is when Bruce Wayne's parents get killed. That was actually really cool. There's some other scenes in there that are really cool, but those go into heavy spoilers. Some of it you've seen in the trailer, some of it you haven't. Some of it's been leaked. You know, that stuff. The music, I gotta say, Junkie XL and Hans Zimmer. I liked Junkie XL on the Amazing Spider-Man soundtrack. I really like that one. I own the soundtrack. Because I was like, the soundtrack was pretty good. They had Alicia Keys on there. You normally don't get Alicia Keys for a Spider-Man film. It just doesn't happen. And I love Hans Zimmer. I've got all the Batman soundtracks. I've got the Superman soundtrack. Not Man of Steel, but Superman Returns. I think he worked on that. But I've got several of his. I'm really a fan of Hans Zimmer. But the soundtrack does not work at all. Especially Wonder Woman's theme. When she comes in, it's like this heavy guitar, like ba-da-da, da-da-da. Like something you'd hear in Halo. It just sounded very disjointed for this female character who's very strong. I mean, like, if you want to, like, give somebody a guitar riff, like, put it that as Batman. That makes a lot more sense. So now we get to the script. Wow, this movie is very disjointed. Holy cow, is this movie disjointed. So, like I said when I was talking to my mom, this feels very much like three movies in one. Each act is its own movie. So, the way it operates is, one, act one, is all the setup for the fight that happens in act two. Then act two ends, and we go into the third act. So, basically, if you want a summary of the acts, act one is the Batman movie. You know, setting up who Batman is, why he's there, why he matters, in what is essentially a Man of Steel sequel, and that goes to Superman. This is basically a Man of Steel sequel. It's been a while since Man of Steel, and you kind of see Clark do some interesting things. You'll see Lois do interesting things. You do see everyone doing their own things in their own worlds, but honestly, the real problem here is Lex Luthor. I'm sorry, Lex Luthor Jr. That pisses me off so much. So I won't say what he's all about. All I'll say is he's very, very, very psychotic. He's like the Joker of the Superman universe, which is really weird to say. He has his hands in everything, but nothing all at the same time. He is maniacal. But the thing is, he's the worst part of this movie. He really, really, really is. There was moments where I was like, oh, he's really selling it. He's really hooking me in. Then the next scene, he just, oh, okay. He's like a child playing in an adult beach. You know? That's really what I feel like. He's small fry. But there's some moments here where you get like some hints at like some of his villainy. And I'm like, ooh, that's Lex Luthor right there. But it's only like hints. So this is very much an origin movie for Lex Luthor as well. As well as Batman. Even though we know Batman's been at it for 20 years. That's what this film says. He's been at it for 20 years. But, and the reason why I say, other than expounding on my three movies in one thing, when I said it's like if Civil War happened when Iron Man came out, I fully mean that. There is so much story and world building in this movie that's setting up for Justice League that I can't ignore it. That it's just like, Justice League members, Justice League members, here they are, here they are. Now, they're relegated to small appearances, but their appearances seem like, oh, look at this, this story point, this entire scene is just to set up Justice League, and there's no real motivation for it. And I'm like, no. And there's this thing that happens towards the third act that I'm just like, damn it, you could have done that in Justice League. Why did you not wait? And I know the storyline very well, almost like there's no emotional impact in this movie at all. And I know that sounds weird to say, coming from an avid comic book fan. I've got a chest over there full of comics. Not just my own, but ones from like 70s, 80s, 90s. Stuff like that. And I'm just like, and by the way, this has no relation to the movie whatsoever. But there's this guy in front of me. So I saw this at the Union Station Theater, which not a lot of people know about. In fact, one of the people that was there knew about it, but, you know, didn't know about it, right? Like, you never really go to a museum to watch a movie. It's just not a common thing. So this guy, utter douche. Utter fucking douche, okay? He was bragging about how, one of his friends was working on the new Lego Batman movie. And sure enough, one of the trailers came on, and it was pretty funny. I'm actually kind of looking forward to it. And you know what the funny thing was? Is there was a Civil War trailer before this movie. I was like, ooh, someone's getting fired for that. Because everything else was all Warner Brothers or Lionsgate, which Warner Brothers owns. So, I was just like, you're gonna get slaughtered for that tomorrow. But anyways, there's a guy in front of me, and he's like, he was talking about the people who were viewing it, and he's like, oh, the story doesn't matter, it doesn't need to have emotional impact. God damn it, yes it does. I don't care who you are, but this guy was, as he said, an avid comic book fan. He's read the story. Which, there's not just one story, in this. There's like thousands, in one. And I was just, that made me so mad. I posted it on Twitter, the paraphrased quote from him. But that made me so mad. And then there was this guy just being really insensitive towards the end of the movie, towards the crowd. And I'm like, dude, you held it in for like 2 hours. You could hold it in for like 30 more minutes. Okay? I almost wanted to sucker punch him. Ugh. Not the guy in front of me. The guy who was hooting and hollering. I'm like, motherfucker. Anyways. Back to the counter review. I'm going to go into the themes. I'll just get straight to my conclusion. This movie is very much too much world building and not enough. It's more Dawn of Justice than it is Batman v Superman, which is ultimately what I came to see. I came to see Batman and Superman throwdown, and it is a very satisfying fight. But it gets just kind of curb stomped by its own story. That, oh, well, there's Aquaman, there's the Flash, there's Cyborg. Like, no. Oh, there's Wonder Woman. No, can you stop? Please stop? No? Okay, you're just gonna keep going. It's stuff like that that really pisses me off because if Iron Man, let's just say hypothetically, in Civil War, Iron Man or Captain America dies, and that happened in their premiere movie. Let's say that happened. You would not have that emotional impact. Or if Civil War even happened and Captain America, the first Avenger, or Iron Man, you wouldn't have that emotional connection to it. You'd just have, oh, well, okay, I guess this is happening. These heroes we don't really know. Like, all we know is Batman and Superman. We don't really know a lot about Batman in this universe, but he's a brutal motherfucker, okay? He straight up kills dudes in this movie, which is kind of odd, because we yes. The Batman that this is based on, Frank Miller's Batman, off the Dark Knight Returns, and Dark Knight Strikes Again, and Dark Knight, Three Master Race. Go read these, by the way. It'll tell you everything you need to know about Batman versus Superman, and you probably need to read, like, some Justice League comics, but other than that. Anyways, I'm just saying that Batman's brutal. Superman is even more devastating in this movie than it is all of Man of Steel. All of Man of Steel, like there's like moments where you're just like, you are evil. You are pure evil. Why are you Superman? Because Superman's been at this for a while. At the start of this movie, and we're just supposed to believe that he's still like wrecking a city, they still letting this happen. Go fucking home. But I will say, this makes me want to read Superman American Alien by Max Landis, because I really enjoyed the stuff with his mom and stuff like that, like the stuff that actually relates to who Superman is as a person. That was really cool. But anyways, at the end of the day, I would have to say, if you're a comic book fan, if you know the insides and outs of what a Batman versus Superman thing should be, as well as a Dawn of Justice, the Dawn of the Justice League, if you know what that is, I highly recommend seeing this movie. So here's what I'm gonna do. For comic book fans, I would rate this movie as probably an A. But here comes the second part. Because a lot of these people who may have an affinity for Batman or Superman or Wonder Woman or Lex Luthor or any of these characters in this universe may go in thinking, oh, I don't need to know a lot about these characters. I kind of do. You need to at least watch Man of Steel. So people who watch Man of Steel, a lot of them just grew up on Superman, knew intimately what Superman was. You will, even if you've watched Man of Steel, you will not understand who Superman is. You need to read at least 5 to 10 different comics, book lines. One I'll specifically mention in my spoiler discussion later this week. And you need to read just basically anything. Superman New 52, Batman New 52, Wonder Woman. This is basically the New 52 of the DC Universe on film. For moviegoers, I say read up on the material, know what you're going into. Maybe look at Google Batman vs. Superman Dawn of Justice comic guide, or what should I know before going into Batman vs. Superman. And if I remember to edit correctly, I'll, because this is going to be a first edit bay thing, I'll have a list of comics for you to read, excluding the ones that have spoilers in the titles. But just since I know more about Batman, I'd definitely say all Frank Miller comics. Batman Year One, Batman The Dark Knight Returns, The Dark Knight Strikes Again. You don't really have to read Master Race just yet, because it's not finished. I'm reading it. I'll probably read some of it tonight. I'm actually kind of behind on that. But go read Frank Miller's run. And probably, if I had to recommend a new Superman story that kind of makes you understand who Superman is as a person, probably Superman American Alien, but I haven't read it. I know a lot of Superman friends recommend that, so I'm going to recommend that. Probably Superman New 52, Wonder Woman New 52, you know, so on and so forth. Scott Snyder's Batman 2. But anyways, that does it. A grade. I need to put a grade on the moviegoer version. For moviegoers, I'd rate this a D-, because it really expects you to know a lot about the DC Universe. That 35% you saw, that's based on moviegoers. So I kind of agree with that, because, I mean, you just need to know a lot, and you don't have that emotional connection that you're supposed to have to these characters if you just go in blind, if you just go in watching Man of Steel, if you just go in watching the Christopher Nolan trilogy, which, I will say, it does not connect to the Nolan trilogy in any way, shape, or form. I hope you liked my review. Like it if you did. Share it with your friends if you thought this was helpful towards deciding whether you're going to go see Batman vs. Superman or not. I mean, I still recommend you go see it, but I mean, if you decide to not go on based on this review, I think you have bigger problems to fry, bigger fish to fry. Subscribe down below if you want to see more of this stuff. But I'll see you on, I guess, Sunday. Would that be a good day to record this spoiler review? Comment down below. And I'll see you next week, maybe. Who knows?